diseases of rapeseed and mustard. Now we will see the list of important diseases in rapeseed as well as in mustard. So the scientific name of rapeseed and mustard is both are Brassica species. Brassica napus and Brassica campestris are the scientific names. So my name is N.H. Shankar Reddy and I am doing PhD plant pathology in Annamalai University. And these are all the list of important diseases in rapeseed and as well as in mustard. Stem rot, which is caused by Sclerotinia, Sclerotiorum. And Alternaria black spot, which is caused by Alternaria brassicae. White rust, which is caused by Albugo candida. Downy mildew, which is caused by Peronospora parasitica. Now we'll see one by one in detail. First one is stem rot, which is caused by Sclerotinia, Sclerotiorum. The clearly we can see the stem is covered with white color mycelial growth. White color mycelial matter, mycelial growth can covers the entire a portion of stem region, and it can also see a black color sclerotial body, say black color sclerotia also produced. So here exactly if you see on the stem regions, so water soaked spots also can be observed along with the cottony white growth of mycelium can be seen on stem regions. So coming to management aspects, so crop rotation with the different types of crops including edible beans, sunflowers, mustard and canola can be recommended, along with avoid planting next to a field which is having Sclerotinia, severe infestation of Sclerotinia. Better to avoid that field which is next to that Sclerotinia infestation, and plants are thoroughly cleaned seeds, and avoiding along with dense stands of canola crops can be avoided. Second one is Alternaria black spot, which is caused by Alternaria brassica. So coming to symptoms, we can see here on the leaf surface we can see brown color discolorations which is covered with yellow color. On the center we can see the brown color discoloration or brown color spots on leaves, and it can be covered by yellow color halo or yellow color discolorations can be seen. And in stems we can see the water soaked spots and that may be covered with cottony growth. So we can rarely see in the basal stalk infection, but mostly we can see this concentric rings. This is the concentric ring, and concentric ring followed by that can be covered by yellow halo. And coming to the management aspects, crop rotation can be helpful for eliminating of the airborne spores from one field to another field, and cleaning the seeds and removal of shrunken infected plants, and as well as using of seeds that having high germination capacity over 90%, and these are all the management aspects. Coming to white rust, which is caused by Albugo candida. So on the right side we can clearly see symptoms mostly we can see on leaves. So white color growth can be seen on lower surface of leaves. On the upper surface of leaves, yellow color spots can be seen. On the lower surface, white color powdery growth or white color dropping like symptoms can be seen. This is a small white color spots. On the upper surface, we can see the yellow color spots or yellow color pustules can be seen on the upper surface or exactly opposite side. This is about white rust. Coming to the management aspects, some of the resistant varieties can be recommended, especially that Argentine resistant varieties are which are resistant to this the disease. And if growing Polish type canola, select resistant varieties. So see current varieties recommendation for the following susceptibility. What are all the current recommendations and agriculture practices that are following in mustard and as well as the rapeseed that can be seen. And crop rotation can be very very important. At least 3 year crop rotation can be recommended, and control volunteer canola and susceptible mustard type weeds in rotation. This is about management aspects. So coming to the downy mildew, which is caused by Peronospora parasitica. Downy mildew, the name itself indicates, on the white color downy growth can be seen on the surface of leaves. So later, I know those spots initially which are angular in color, we can see later on upper surface, we can see it's a little bit angular transculent light green spots can be seen, which are irregular, and in later stages necrotic patches can be seen. Initially downy growth can be seen on the lower surface, on the upper surface on white, little bit of white color spots, and along with the transculent green patches can be seen. And later stages this will slowly leads to death. And the stem of flowers clusters become swollen, the stem regions and as well as the flower clusters region because slowly they are swollen. And coming to the management, destroy the crop refuse and along with the crop rotation can be recommended. So coming to the questions related to ARS or NET, we may see in the causal organisms of disease. Rather than that, there is nothing much important from this, especially this rapeseed as well as mustard.